Hi friends, welcome to Success Learners channel. My name is Balaji. Today I am going to explain you guys about the effective utilization of the classes in the Quinter toolkit for the implementation of this graphical user interface. So before going to discuss the classes implementation in this Quinter toolkit, let's see the basics of what this class and what this init methods on what is this if name equals to main. See these things. Let's see what is this class mean by. A class is a user defined prototype, like it's not predefined, it is going to be user defined prototype for an object that defines the set of attributes. Attributes like data members or the methods or the functions that are going to be accessed via dot method in this class. So I think you get a clarity about this class. It is a user defined prototype. That's it. You can list out the figures, like you can add like functions, methods and data members into this class, and then you can access them by getting the dot method. And coming to this init self method, so actually this init self, it is a predefined class constructor, default class constructor. This is a default class constructor where this init method has its importance in this OOP concept, like object oriented programming. It is known as default class constructor. Why? Because this method can be called when it is created from the class and access is required to initialize the attributes. Whenever you needed, like if you want to initialize any attributes, then we are going to call this function. Like this is a default class constructor, we named it as a constructor. That's it. And coming to this here, if name equals to main, so we are going to use this name equals to main when we are importing some modules, like when we are importing some modules like Quinter toolkit, then in that type of situations we are going to use this one defaultly. For each and every script we are going to write this if name equal to main. This is the just we are going to use this one, like we are going to know that if the script or the method is going to be run under the name of main or it is running under the name of the module imported. So that's it all about this. Each and every script that should be run under this main, so we are checking whether it is going to be run under this main or not. It should not run under this imported module. That's why we see for each script we write like if name equal to main. That's it. And let's move on to this Quinter toolkit. Like let's import Quinter toolkit, like Quinter as TK. So we are importing Quinter and we are going to name it as it is a dummy name, like TK, and then what we are going to do, and then we are going to call this class here. So class of TK dot capital TK. So where this is initializing this one, this is initializing this one, and then after the initialization we have to give the title here. So before giving the title, we have to name the class here. These are the arguments we are just initializing. We have to name the class. What is the name of the class? We are going to create a window, so let's define the name as window. So we named the class as window and we are passing the TK dot capital TK, which is going to initialize the window, and then we have to inherit some properties from super class. So first we have to define the default class constructor. So default, what is the default class constructor? Like it is the init here, we define it here. We are going to get this here. So in itself, under this, we have to import that super module. Why? Because from the super class, we are going to take some inherit some properties. So super dot init. So we are going to again call that super dot init. Why? Because we have to initialize that super class. That's why we are calling this default constructor there itself. And then here we don't require this one. And again, then we are going to call this self here. So which self is the argument that initializes using the dot operator. So dot title. So we are going to give the title here. That's why we have to name, or we have to initialize that self dot title. So it will initialize that, and let's name it as hello folks. Hello folks, let's write the window name as a hello folks, and then let's create a label here. So that label, how we are going to access this label using TK, this, let's call it event here, event dot label. So label, there is a keyword in this Kinter toolkit, so label of. So in this label, we have to call that event. So what is that event going to be happen like? It is the self in this default constructor. So we are going to call that self here, and then we have to call, and then we have to write something like to show that it is going to be work. We are going to write something on this. That's why we are going to call a text over there. Let's call print like success learners here. Success learners here, and let's see the next one. Like, we have to pack that, so we have to pack this label. So this pack label is nothing, it is similar to the grid as we just seen in the previous videos. We are going to define like a dot grid here when we are going to see that entry or other information regarding this calculator. We use grid. The same functionality done by this packing, but some extra features that are available in this packing. So many coders use pack rather than the grid. So let's define this label here, label dot pack. So we are packing the label with, we have to fill that widget or the window using the both sides. So we have to keep like with fill tk dot both, so it will give the proper alignment in the both sides. For this text, it will give the proper alignment, like same it will be in the middle of the widget or the window. That's why we are going to use this both here. Why? Because this widget will take to the space in the both directions, then it will be look like in the, it is in the middle. So it is in the center itself. So then it's look very pretty good. That's why we are going to use this both method. Otherwise it will show from, it will show in the first starting or starting at the left side, or it will be unable to recognize fastly. That's why we are going to use this both method here. And then we have to call that expand. This is also a label option that we can select expand equals to one or two. How much should want to expand, you can expand that much amount by seeing, by throwing two or three times operations performing on it, you will know how to make that one. And then we have to pad that. I told us about the padding in the last video, like a pad, it will give a rectangular format to this in the both directions, like pad x means horizontally and pad y means vertically. So we are going to pad this into 100 pixels in the x direction, like horizontal direction, and we are going to pad the y direction in 50 pixels. After this completing the packing of the label, we have to call this if method, if name equals to run. Under this we are going to define, like, we have to create a variable for the function like window. We are going to call this window class here. We are going to define window of, we are calling this function, and we are going to assign this window function, window class, to the variable w. So whenever we are going to call this w here, the function will be invoked. So we are invoking the class like w dot main loop. So main loop here. So under this main loop only, this all the widget or the window is going to be packed. So let's see the output here, what it's going to be. It's throwing an error like super objects need an argument. Like init of, so let's, we forgot to call the self here. Let's run this one. No. While we are calling the super class, we have to define it as a function here. So it is also a class. When we are going to call the class, let's see here we are calling the class here using this brackets. So whenever we are going to inherit the properties from a super class, we have to call it with a super of brackets here. So let's see the output. I think then now it's not going to show any error. There is an error from 12th line. Window of. So here guys, I given here like pan by. It is pad by. So the error is occurring. Sorry for the. See here, it is showing that hello folks, and that it is calling like success learners is going to print in this widget. If you want to make it bigger, select font here, font that equals to Times New Roman. It is Times New Roman, and the size should be 30. And it should be in the bold. Let's run this one. See here, it is in bold with 30. If you want to make this width broader, like width that is equals to 100, let's make it width bigger. See here, you can make the width also. So in this way we are going to use the classes in this Kinter toolkits. This is a small example for this classes, how we are going to use this effectively in Kinter toolkits. From next video onwards, we are going to see some big projects regarding this classes and Kinter toolkits. That's it guys. If you have any doubts or queries in this topic, please let me know in this comment section. Thank you guys.